thank you. Every time I tell him thanks, he gives you $100. Can you give him thanks just a couple more seconds tonight? Shout thank you. Oh, hallelujah. When I studied kingdoms, I discovered, here's what it says in my studies. It says, gratitude attracts a king's favor. Number four, submission to a king's lordship means you have no right to yourself. When you submit to his ownership, you are telling him, I don't own myself. I am God's property. Everything I have is his property. You cannot call him Lord and say, but. The two words can never go together. Lord, but. Impossible. He owns and he claims. It's impossible to live in a kingdom if you don't submit totally to the king. He has to own you to protect you. He has to own you to feed you. He has to own you to provide for you. He has to own you. Number five, obedience is acknowledgement of the lordship of the king. Do you know how a person becomes what we call born again or saved, whatever the word you use? It's very simple, you know. The Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse 17, if thou wilt confess with thy mouth, what? Jesus Christ is Lord. It didn't say Savior. Lord. If you confess, he is my owner, he said, you got citizenship. And if you are a citizen, I am totally responsible for your life. All your worries just went away. Glory, hallelujah. How about calling him Lord a couple of times right now? You are my Lord. You are my Lord. You own me. You are my Lord. Number six, thanksgiving is admission and acknowledgement of the king's lordship. Thanksgiving is you admitting that he is owner. Thanksgiving is admitting that you acknowledge that he is owner of everything. He's Lord. Let me put it another way. Oh, really? Oh, okay. The exam was quick. Well, I can see you all tomorrow. I don't know what they do with this time. Somebody is doing something with my time back there. In the name of Jesus. Can I complete my sentences? Okay. And then I go in home too. Number seven. Lord can never be used with the word but. Don't ever use it. You can't tell him he owns you and then put a condition somewhere. Do you remember when Jesus told a story? Well, actually it wasn't a story. These disciples tried to follow him and they said, I will follow you, but first let me go and bury my father. And Christ says, what are you talking about? Let the dead bury your dead. You come and preach with me, he says, because if you turn back, you are not fit to be in my kingdom. Specific words, kingdom. You can't be in my kingdom and tell me you're going to go bury somebody first. If I don't own you, you can go bury them. If I own you, you decide, if I decide whether you bury them or not. He was trying to make a point. One of them said, let me go and sell my land and do real estate. But he said, no. You leave that real estate, you come to me. If I'm your Lord, you do what I say. Total ownership. So what is Lord? I think it's important to get the definition. Here's my research for you. The word Lord or Lordship is from the word, a number of words. The Greek word is kurios. And here's what it means. It means having power over something. It also means ultimate authority over something. It also means to master something. Kurios, Lord, Hebrew. This is why slaves were owned by what they call kurios, a master. Slaves call their owners masters because the owner owned them. They call them Lord, kurios. whoever is your Lord is totally responsible for your life. Say that with me. Whoever is your Lord is totally responsible for your life. That's why Sarah was smart. A lot of women still haven't learned what my wife figured out. My wife figured out a long time ago. She told me, you are my Lord, you own me. That's not a blessing to me. She telling me, if I don't look good, it's your fault. If I don't smell good, it's your fault. If I don't feel good, it's your fault. If I don't act good, it's your fault. I am your property. See if some of it ain't figured out yet. Hallelujah. The Bible says, women, be like Sarah, who called Abraham Kurios. You own me, baby. So if you don't like how I look, dress me up. Smart woman. Master. You hear the words of Jesus? He said, you call me Lord, but don't do what I say. You say, I own you, and you still sleep where you want to sleep. You still drink what you want to drink. You still smoke what you want to smoke. You lying. I ain't your Lord. That's why he says, many shall say, Lord, Lord. But I will say, I never knew you. You did what you felt like. It's kingdom living. Kingdom living. Don't you ever call him Lord. And then do what you feel like again. Because thou art a liar. Look at the Hebrew word. This word means owner, proprietor. Write it down. The word also means one who controls. Lord, owner, proprietor. The only Lord that you know right now in your life is the landlord, the one you're renting from. You're renting a building, it's called the landlord, right? That's where they get the word from. It's from the Bible. It's from kingdoms. Now, what's the Hebrew word? The Hebrew word is an interesting word in the Old Testament. It's the word Yehovah. We've long said Yahweh, Jehovah. And it actually means self-existent one. This also is used for the proper name of God and should have been retained in that form by the translator. Matter of fact, the word Yahweh is also from the root word Adon. We got a word Adonai from. The word Lord is Yahweh. Adonai, Adon, and it means ownership. By the way, all this research came from the dictionaries of the Hebrew. Now, this is important. The word Lord means Yahweh, Adonai, and it means master, owner, controller. So let's take it to its natural conclusion. Worship is expected in a kingdom because you are in a nation where the ruler owns everything. Hebrews 12 verse 28 says, therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be what? Thankful. And so, worship God acceptably. In other words, hey, it's natural. If you're in a kingdom, you start thanking. And you never stop thanking. Anybody getting this? Yep. That means Sunday morning or Saturday morning, whenever you worship, no one should get you started. Don't need no organ, no drums, no music, no worship leader. Matter of fact, the Paul says when you come together, each one come with their own hymn and their song and their spiritual song. Why? They've been singing all day. They just got to come together with a few thousand more. We're just going to sing our songs together. That's why worship services can be so heavy because it's religion. The fact that you made it through the traffic should get you started from the yard. Come on, somebody. The parking lot should be full of water. Oh, Jesus, Lord. Thank you. Hey, thank you. Hey, I made it through. Thank you. Hey, I made it through. Thank you. By the time I get in the room, it's an experience.